A big trend, in my opinion, is that in the past years, almost all publishing houses, TV stations have published websites and tried to make free content. And only few websites were successful with this because they were so big that they could monetize it in a way. They earned good contribution margins. And it turns out that at least in Germany, only 3 to 4 websites are profitable. So there is a big trend right now to go to paid content. And it is a big dilemma that, for example, TV stations will still have open websites, and private companies will have to introduce paid content and paywalls. And we see some initiatives of publishing houses to introduce paid content for content which has been free before. And this is a thing which is everybody talking and thinking about. And in my opinion, it is very open if that succeeds. Okay. And in the case for our company, the only paid content we have is what have been magazines in the past, which have had a price. Our objective is to bring those magazines into the digital mobile world and to maintain a price for it also in this world. But for the lower quality website content, I actually think it's very difficult to establish paid content.
Okay.
Freedom of press is a big word. At least at our publishing house, we see a very interesting tendency. Der Spiegel is a political magazine, and in the future, for example, at 9/11, when the World Trade Center crashed, we could realize very high circulation also in print. And when now catastrophes occur, like Fukushima, this almost has no effect on the printed circulation. It's like everything which is happening right now, and where you want to have a information for the moment, the printed media almost plays no role anymore, and we need to define ourselves, and this whole business goes to websites. So this could be something which could answer your question, that of course online media is going to be the first source for everything, and of course plays an important role for the freedom of press. Nevertheless, freedom of press also means everybody can publish, but of course it's important for persons in a country to rely on those information. And I think it's almost not affordable for a good publishing house to make everything for free. So this is a dilemma which we are going to run in. That's exactly the point. When for publishing houses or websites, it's no longer possible to create a journalism in a way we used to do it, to have checks on quality and to send journalists into the world and to bring the information as it would supposed to be, the quality is going down. So, of course, other competitors force us to make products actually which are not as good as they used to be before.
Mm-hmm. How important is interaction to you?
Well, If you had asked Katharina Borchardt, who is the managing director of Spiegel Online, she would have answered interaction is totally important. And I completely agree on the fact that the information is going to social media and the information is rather coming to you because you have somewhere marked what is going to interest you, and the path of information is now completely different. I'm not sure whether the interaction for companies who are making information is that important, because since everybody can publish, it's rather the role of big brands to give orientation, and giving orientation is still something which goes from one direction into the other, and it might become more important to have interaction, but it's not in a way that it is going to change the business completely. Yes, with our websites, of course, we use social media, and we also make the experience that social media is an important source also for the websites to get those persons to us, even though we see that for many users it's enough what we post in social media, and this is a trend that maybe consumers are content with fewer information or with little information, which is rather a tendency which might be not that good. And in this way we use it, and of course we want to stay in touch with customers, and so it's we have to be there. Spiegel Online is a successful website, but it is successful because the processes are different than in print. In print there are relatively high paid editors, every article is getting checked and double checked, and we have editorial teams and all in every spot in the world. And because this works, because the business model is excellent with the distribution and advertising market. Mm-hmm. Having the online world only with the advertising market, the contribution margin is much lower, and we can only be profitable when the journalists are getting paid worse. If there is no fact-checking department, there is nobody who is correcting texts, almost nobody, and you can say that the quality in professional means is not as good as in print. For magazines which publish investigative stories, they have always been relying on information of citizens who are well informed and know things others don't know. So this might be another name for an old thing.